Outdoor landscape here, watercolor. So while working in watercolor, the speed and the dynamics of the medium is important. So it is good to start with some value sketch, absorb the whole atmosphere. I mean, it's always a good idea to do a sketch within a rectangle. A rectangle plays an important role here. Many a times people carry a smaller rectangle cut in the place. I prefer to use my rectangle. But the whole thing is dividing the scene into that rectangle actually makes you feel like you are already starting the whole thing. The whole thing starts in the mind. The two figures, I have just sketched them for the reference later on. And basically I am trying here is the value. The darkest dark, the middles, and just smudge around, and that's enough. The value sketch is so important that I have already got my plan ready, you see. Then we don't have much time to stop and think. So your plan to be ready to some extent is very important. Since my drawing is on here, I'm just putting down some a little addition to the drawing. These are the shadows of the tree, but they are also going to help me with my washes, with correcting my washes, placing my washes in the right place. The shadow color is mainly, it's grey, it looks grey, but it has a very cool color on it. Obviously in outdoor, every shadow has a cool reflection of the sky in it. So that white kind of looks a little violetish, bluish and brown. These are what you call that Nilgiri tree, eucalyptus tree. So they are basically white trunks. And let's see. I think there are too many trees in front of me, but that much is enough. Now this yellow, I start with the foliage around, foliage of the tree. I have to be a little careful here to leave a little white edge around the trunk. And little darks coming up down. These leaves are never exactly green. I mean, there is yellow, brown, all kinds of shades you see. And the trees in the distance are blue. So actually you have to be ready for any color. The foliage essentially is not always green. There are many different colors. And little sparkle, this is basically to create a little interest of the design. As I come down to the grass on the ground, I'm taking a little more greenish, a little sap and viridian mixed together. Makes a convincible grass shade. Be okay. But once it's good to take a look back in front of you. And of course I'm working in the speed, but it's good to take a back and wait for a second and then go ahead. The road in between, which is passing through the grass, it's brown. So okay, I'm starting with a brown kind of look, but I'm adding a pure red. You see, the colors are getting mixed on the paper itself. Why not pure red plus little orange, and plus you can add green, it becomes brown. But what mixes on the paper looks more interesting than what mixes on the palette in watercolor. So it's a very good idea to mix directly on the paper itself, because then you have the freshness of the mix somehow. Further going to the little sparkling highlight trees, I'm establishing the entire light area. You can notice that. And a little careful on the figures. They are mostly in the shadow, but they are retaining a little bit of highlight since they are against the background. And their shadows falling on the road. Of course, the two women have already gone past. but I remember what they looked like. And now I can start freely with the background since I have my lights established in places. So it's against the light, against it, it is at distance, so it is almost looking like a bluish violetish gray, and with a hint of green, of course, which is the local color of the trees. But I'm not, what I can see is not green since it's against light. And I do see a little bit of reds because there are always some kind of dry leaves around which predominantly show the red. The blue thing, the red thing. The important thing is the background has to be homogeneous, a very homogeneous wash. Whatever colors you might go here and there, but there shouldn't be any sharp edge seen anywhere. Otherwise, it will not give you the look of background as such. It comes into foreground the moment sharp areas comes. So I fairly manage the color as well as the blend of the background. And again, painting around the figure is a critical thing. You have to be careful. And yet not leaving a sharp edge there. Yeah, that's the dark foliage, I mean dark hedge which I see, which is looking far more greener than the background actually. And in fact, that green in the shadow is defining the color of the hedge, which is much freshly watered than the other tree, rest of the tree, I believe. And now the most important part of shadows. The shadow color is always critical. It has a lot of reflected lights, but the easiest trick is there are some warm reflections, there are some cool reflections. So the color shouldn't be only warm or only cool. If it blends between the warm and cool, it convincingly looks like a shadow. The shadow shapes are important. Once you establish, you have a good color and a tone of shadow that satisfies you. These shapes are, I believe, the most important thing in a landscape. Because the shape of the shadow defines the shape of the light. And obviously, the light and shade are, you can't ignore, they are very important in a scene like this, very nicely sunlit scene. So, let us be careful while doing this. When it comes to a large mass of shadow, it cannot have the same tone where those tiny masses are there. Those are much darker. If I use a darker mass here, it will create a blob or a hole. So I have to show more reflected lights in the darker masses. And the smaller masses comparatively are darker in color but sharper also. Yeah, again, if you notice that same red now, which is more brownish, of course, because mixed with green, vermilion red, that is establishing the color of the ground. Many a times we have a very small area in light, and actually the light, if you want to show the light, you can't have a local color. It is much, much, much brighter or lighter than that. But then the color in the shadow will define that the ground was reddish. Yeah, now going back to the darks of the... Again, as much as shadow, these things are important because these darks, well connected, will tie the whole picture. Lights can get scattered anywhere, but darks have to be connected because the first thing anyone notices in a painting is not the lights. The first thing that takes your attention are the darks. So if the darks are scattered all around, it is bound to look scattered painting. the darks are actually holding the painting, the structure of the painting. So that connectivity of the dark creates a unity. And obviously when I make a background dark, the lighter foliage of the front trees, that comes out. Again, those small washes which I had given in the earlier, small bushes like thing which are in the sunlight, they are highlighted. So I believe now the major establishment is already made of the tonal pattern. It's simple, it's one light, one dark and one middle tone. If you place these three things in place, your painting is in place. Then everything rest is just addition and glorification of the painting. The details are very interesting, but unless your darks, middle tones and lights are not the way you want, I don't think you'll be satisfied with whatever amount of detailing you do later on. So this is the fundamental structure, and I'm quite happy here. Now as you see, this is a crucial point. I wasn't very sure I'm going to draw the tree in the left hand side. If you see it, it's a huge dark mass on the left hand side. But unless you dare and attempt, you never know whether it will work or not. As it is right now, the painting is almost sufficient, but one has to take the risk. So let's see what happens if I actually do. It might work, it might give a better depth to the whole painting, or it might not, who knows. Now there are many shapes, many tiny speckled shapes, but I'll connect them together later on, don't worry. I could have done this with a large bold washes and just making the edges into little leaves. But that would have been a safer way. I've done it previously. This is something which in every painting I have to try something new. So, and this is not the usually I paint a tree, but this time I want to try painting this way. See, the masses are again connected, but somewhere you see the contour which defines the character of that particular tree. That is important. The hedges actually are looking much darker than I thought they would be. And no harm in making them a little more darker. I think that's almost, we are at the end of the session. The figures, let them define little more. These two women were walking and talking, and I can call this painting a morning walk talk. Of course, these detailing have to be very homogeneous. That's more important. You can go on and on with it, but the entire homogeneity of the brush strokes, there are large washes, large strokes. So that's it. I think the best way to stop any painting is just put your name down there. Thank you.